تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والصلاة والسلام على من بعثه ربه تعالى ليكون للعالمين نذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا نشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وعد الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين أما بعد يقول الله تبارك وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأبي بكر أنت صاحبه في الغار وأنت معي على الحوض أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام honorable scholars, respected brothers, mothers, elders, and the listeners of ITV International, welcome back again to our second part of the life of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and where we discuss different aspects of the life of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So just for the reflection of the moment, we're living in the world where we are lacking of moral and ethical leadership based on divine revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the only way out of that is if we can only get out of that, this problem, only if we can learn the lives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the life of his companions, and mostly importantly, the life of the best man, the best person, the best companion after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the man who encompassed or the man who encapsulated all the aspects of life within himself. So just for a recap, last time we discussed about the life of this great man, especially his life before Islam, and then we discussed some of his titles. One of them was Al-Atiq, and then of course another one was As-Siddiq. And then we discussed also, we explained why was he given those titles. And then one of those things which we have discussed in the past, it was his physical features of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And one of those things was that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was on the companion or one person who was known as a person with his skinned body. So, but then again, that could not prevent Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu to defend his deen, to defend the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that did not let him down when it comes to defend also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So to support my claim of the strength and the braveness of this companion, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, let me take you into the incidents of which happened after the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, the news broke out all over Medina, and then fortunately it reached to the Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So when this news of the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam reached to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he rushed quickly, and then he took his conveyance of his, and then he went to the masjid. And then when he reached to the masjid, he didn't wait. He went straight to the masjid without talking to anyone. And then when he get into the masjid, he went to the apartment to the Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And then when he get there, he went straight to where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, our body was. And then when he get there, he exposed the blessing face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then he found that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had really passed away. And then when he saw this, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he made a statement that all the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot gather two death upon you. As for the death which was destined for you, for verily you have just studied. So at this moment, before Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala who arrived at this place, Umar radiallahu ta'ala who had already announced that if anyone is going to speak about the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, definitely I'm going to cut off his head. And then, as we all know that Umar radiallahu ta'ala who was known as a person who no one would take chance, or he was a very brave person, and he was a very short-tempered person. And then when he announced this, everyone was quiet, especially those who were closest to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because it was a very, very sad reality. No one could believe that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has really left in this world. He went back to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he exposed the face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then he realized that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he passed away. There's no way out to bring him back into this life. And then he went out where he found Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who at this time was on the minbar, was continuing admonishing people and telling people that if anyone is going to stand up and announce that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has passed away, I'm going to chop his off his head. And then at this time, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he saw that Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he's telling people this. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, of course, he was also afflicted with his the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But since he did not have choice but to accept the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he went forward and he told Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, "Oh Umar, ala rislika ya Umar." Idlis. Then he told Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, "Oh Umar, take it easy. Please do me a favor. Sit down." And then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he sat down. When he sat down, then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he went forward and then he announced to people the first admonishment, the first statement of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, which he did there, or which he quoted. He first praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorified him. Then after, he made a statement where he said, "Man kana minkum ya'budu Muhammadan fa inna Muhammadan qad mat, wa man kana ya'budu Allah fa inna Allah hayyun la yamut." O people, take note. If anyone amongst you used to worship the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then from now on you have to know that indeed Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has passed away. But if there is anyone amongst you who used to make ibadah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then great tidings to him. Let him know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all alive, and he will always be there forever. He hayyun la yamut. He does not pass away, and he will never. And then when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu made that statement, and then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he heard this, he said, at least this time Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was very afflicted. But after this statement of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he realized that indeed Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu is a great man. And this is one of the proofs which shows that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was a very brave man and a very steadfast person, and he was only the companion who was able to overcome the situation, especially in this situation, the most crucial occasion, because it is not easy for the person to lose a person who was most beloved to him, because this was a very, very tough time to the companions, and of course to everyone in the Medina. So the narration, it has mentioned that there was no any Sahaba who could understand that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, indeed he has gone away to the Prophet, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then one of those companions who were so much in pain and grief because of the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of them was Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he even lost the ability of speaking, and never leave alone Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because him, it is said that he even went to seclusion because he was not able to overcome this situation. But Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he managed to overcome this, and then he announced this. And then when he finished that, telling people that if anyone amongst you was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he have to continue. And then he recited the verse, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُولُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ انْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبْ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا وَسَيَجْزِي الشَّاكِرِينَ. And then Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, after the Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala mentioned this verse, then it was as if the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum, it was as if it was their first time to hear this ayah, but yet it was there, right there in the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said, if there's something else to indicate or to prove the braveness of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, indeed this is a most and a very reliable source, and as well as a proof that showing that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, of course he was a person of a skinned body, but yet he had a very brave and a very steadfastness when it comes to overcoming the different situation. And of course it was a very difficult and tough for him to understand this, but because of the love and ability of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him, he managed to overcome this. And this is a very proof which indicating the braveness of this Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We'll come back inshallah ta'ala, where we're going to discuss another aspect of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu inshallah. Welcome back again. We're going to discuss now other aspect of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, mainly when it comes to the love and the love which he did have for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So my brothers and sisters, the love that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it was a very, very strong love. It was very intensive love that he had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Honestly speaking, there's no any word which can actually do justice to express how much love did this person had for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it is mentioned that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was only the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam who could speak openly against the mushrikun to defend the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, mostly in the occasion or in the cases where all the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were afraid to be victimized and to be tortured by Quraysh. According to the riwayah of Zubair ibn Awam, he said, he asked Amir ibn As radiallahu ta'ala anhu that what was the worst thing that the Quraysh ever did to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? And Amir ibn As explained that it was only one occasion when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was reading his salah at the edge of the Kaaba, or at the side of the Kaaba. And when one of the mushrik, he ran, he came into the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then he grabbed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's neck, and then he wrapped with his clothing. And then because of this, it caused the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam not to breathe well. And then he starts violently shaking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu saw this, he rushed and then he pushed this mushrik, and then he said, "Wailak, ataqtulu rajulan ay yaqula rabbi Allah?" What a heartless person are you? How could you kill a person just because he's saying my Rabb is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How could you? You can see from this that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he did have the love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And according to the one narration, it is mentioned that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they were both in the masjid, and they were having some interaction with the kuffar. And then as the interaction was carrying on, And then the Prophet ﷺ, of course, started to inviting them into the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then after the Prophet ﷺ, as he was inviting them, the Quraysh, they stood up, they say, how dare are you? How dare are you that you criticize our Lord? And then because the Quraysh, after they heard this statement, they didn't feel comfortable with it. And then they start now torturing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And according to another riwayah, they say they were almost to attack and torture and to assassinate the Master sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And another riwayah said they even beat him, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the extent that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he lost his consciousness. And then when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu see this, he made a statement. He said, "Wailakum, what evil people are you? Ataqtuluna rajulan an yaqula rabbi Allah? Do you have to kill a person just because he's saying my Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" And then the infidel Quraysh, when they see that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was a man of less dignity than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they started now torturing him and beating him up. And the riwayat says that they come to an extent that they took off their shoes, then started beating the face of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, to the extent that it was the people, they were not able to show where Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala eyes were, because he was bleeding so muchly. And then when this Quraysh beat them this much, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he also fell into consciousness throughout the whole day. And then the Quraysh, the family of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, when they saw this, they announced that if it happened that this man is not going to wake up, he's going to pass away, you're going to pay, or we're going to literally yet on the behalf of this person. But then it was not the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not yet upon him. It happened that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, then he started now slowly waking up. And then when he woke up, the first thing he did, the first statement he did, he asked, "Aina Muhammad? Ma fa'ala Muhammad? Where is the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How is the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doing?" So at this time, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala's parents, they were not yet a Muslim. So you can understand the pain and the agony of the parents realizing that these things is happening because of such and such a person, and yet they don't like him. You can understand so much frustration which can come into the life of this kind of parents. But then when they reached there, people, they carried him into Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala's parents. When they reached there, they put him in the room. And then when they put him in the room, Abu Quhafa, the father of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, who was not a Muslim at that time, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he carries on, "Aina Muhammad, Aina Muhammad." Then he got so furious and irritated. "Why? What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? Where is Muhammad? You're asking where is Muhammad? You just got beaten because of that same Muhammad you are talking about. Why don't you keep quiet? Don't you have anything else to say?" Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala say, "Oh my mother, I'm not going to eat or to move any inch unless I see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." And Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, that time his father, he walked away out of the room, and then he was left there with his mother. And then his mother, after seeing the pain and the agony of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, which he was going through at that time, then he realized that there's nothing which I can do but then to take him to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But then she didn't have choice because she was alone. Then she went out to call some lady who was the sister of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When she came, they carried him on their shoulders, going to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, dragging his legs. And then when he reached there to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he began to cry. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also began to cry. And of course, those companions who were there next to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they also cried. Just imagine, the love of this person which he did have for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So from this, it is not amazing or something strange that to call this man that he was only the best and the role model, the best person in this ummah after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. According to another narration, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned that it was one morning when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came to the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came to the house of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, so people, they were amazed because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were not used to see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that particular time. But then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is wrong on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he could always go to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to visit him. But this time the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came there, he was covering his head. And then when he reached there, the Prophet Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala asked him, what is wrong? Then Abu Bakr the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, who are you with? Then the Prophet Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he responded, say, of course, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I'm with your family. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, you know what, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, I have been commanded to migrate to Medina. And then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, who after hearing this, he said, as-suhbatu ya Rasulullah. O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, can you please take me as your companion? And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, of course, you are granted permission to accompany me, to take you as my companion on this journey. And Aisha radiallahu ta'ala mentioned that it was my first time seeing the person crying out of their happiness. When Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala heard this, he cried. Because why? He knew that he's going to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and hence this was his wish to always be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala was waiting for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go for Hijrah, and other companions, they were already left fearing of their body, and then they were left already. They went already to Medina, and then the Prophet remained behind with Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So in another narration, according to the riwayah of this incident of the calf, it is mentioned that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they left going for Hijra. As they were going and they marched towards the cave, as they reached there, before they reached there, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of course, like, he got tired, and because like it was a quite long journey, and then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he got tired. When they reached there, then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, please wait here. Let me go inside and I clean the cave. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he went there. When he went there, he made sure to clean everything. And of course, there were some holes there. And Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he made sure to close all the holes there. And he used his garment, the piece he teared in two pieces, then he make sure to close all the holes. But then his clothes then ran out. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he didn't want to make his life difficult, of course. Then when he saw that he finished to cover all the holes, but the only two holes left there was left to cover. And then he called the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come in. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came in. When he came in, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, obviously, he was tired already. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wanted to rest. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you can rest here on my thigh. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he rested there. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was resting, and then those two holes which was left, which he didn't cover, the Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he placed his feet in there. And then as the Prophet was resting, when the snake came out from there, then it bit Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. And this time he felt so painful, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, to such an extent that he could not bear the pain of which he was going through at that particular time. But then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he didn't feel comfortable to shake or to wake the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because it was hard for him to bring any inconvenience to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What he did, he didn't shake, but then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, because of the pain which he was going through, the tears starting coming out from his eyes, of which now it fell down on the cheeks of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which caused the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to wake up. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam woke up, he asked Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, "What is wrong, O Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu?" Of which he replied, he said, "Oh, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know there was these holes," and he explained the whole incident, what happened. Then he said, "No, I didn't have that courage, you know, to wake you up. To bring any inconvenience to you. That's why I didn't wake you up." So from this you can see how much love did Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he did have for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And just before I conclude, I would like to share with you some of the golden couplets of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, wish for death, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would increase you long and healthy life. And he say, help your brother when he's in need, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will help you. And the last but not least, he said, speak less so that you don't forget much important. And the poem says, to support this, the poem says, "Ma in nadimtu ala sukuti marra, wa laqad nadimtu ala al-kalami mirara," that in life there was a many numerous instant of which there was not a numerous instant where I regretted because I kept quiet, but there was many time of which I regretted because I speak. So with this, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you and I the tawfiq and ability of internalizing and the learning and the practicing the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and of course the life of his companion. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala infuse and imbibe within me and you the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and of course the love of his companion. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.